is the Lexus LFZC concept, and it is set to debut in production form around 2026. Now, what we have here is really a very sleek sedan-like EV. And as you can see, one of the signature features is the Lexus spindle right here, but closed off for electrification. Now, one of the things that's very interesting, as you can see, this car is very low slung, so it is meant to give it a very sort of aggressive and really provocative sort of look. And it still maintains that Lexus signature. If you look at the Lexus RZ EV, there's still the commonality there. So as you can see, because there's no need for an engine in an electric vehicle or a transmission, Lexus was able to push the wheels really to the corner of the car. So that allows the wheelbase to be lengthened, which allows for more cabin space inside. Now we come along the side here, you can see sort of this very sort of geometric pattern right here along the side of the car, and then also sort of a sort of sloping effect, like a hockey stick effect along the front sort of half of the car. And then nice little sort of personalization feature with the Lexus sort of badging, and it looks like that can be illuminated. Also right here, there's a vent. There's no fakery in this vent. It does allow air to pass through, and that really helps with the efficiency. And I don't know if this will make it to production, but these mirrors, obviously they're very small. They are camera type mirrors on the car. And as you can see, sort of the strip kind of follows along. I don't believe that's an illuminated strip, but we'll be able to confirm that more as we get closer to production. Now, if we just look at the car overall, it has really sort of a very kind of interesting look to it. Sort of this fast back look where it's not really a conventional sedan, but more of sort of a hatchback type style. It really works. It will make you pay attention to it. It is a very long car, so there's been rumors about whether this will be the Lexus IS successor, but this is something different entirely. I would say sort of maybe Lexus GS type class, or maybe even sort of a sport tuned version of the Lexus LS. And again, Lexus is able to achieve that by taking out sort of the front motor and the transmission in the vehicle. Now, if we come around to the back, you can see we've got this LED light bar that really comes all the way around to the back. Nice signature here that goes right into the Lexus logo. And then you've got sort of these vertical or sort of L-shaped LED lights right here, which gives really sort of a cool character to the car. And this is pretty cool right here, how they've handled sort of the rear window sloping into sort of the back down onto the rear bumper right here. And then some nice shoulders on the car as well. Very edgy. There's really very few smooth surfaces on this car. So edgy in the literal sense is what this Lexus LFZC is. Now, I will not give my impressions in terms of the look. I'd like to hear what you think about it. And so leave your comments in the comment section below. But it's definitely something interesting, and right or wrong, it's definitely going to get some attention. Now, if we take a look at the inside of the Lexus, we can see that we've got some sustainable materials here. One of the goals is to make the car circular through the use of sustainable materials, so bamboo being one of those materials. And it's part of the position bamboo sort of theme that Lexus has, and that's going to find its way into future Lexus vehicles. Also, the nice thing about this treatment with the bamboo is that it's actually a breathable material. And so the bamboo in this Lexus LFZC and the other Lexus vehicles that will be using bamboo is that the car can really sort of, in some ways, offset its CO2 emission through the absorption of CO2 inside the material. Now, Lexus has been known for really integrating some very innovative styling treatments in their cars, and this is no different in the Lexus LFZC. So in future Lexus, you will see these types of materials in the car, and yeah, very creative sort of a function or features of the car that are also sustainable. Now, if we continue on, you can see that there is a lot of space in this vehicle here, and so you've got sort of this sort of Czech floor pattern using sustainable materials, a lot of sort of storage in here, and really just an open, airy cockpit, and that is by design from Lexus. So the goal is to really give the car a nice, large greenhouse, right, but also maximizing the use of space, again, with the long wheelbase and it being on an electrified platform. And then in the rear right here, there is a really sort of interesting concept in terms of the ability to wirelessly charge your phones or use them as an entertainment device, as well as the tablet displays on the headrest here. And once again, there are those sustainable materials inside this Lexus LFZC. And bucket seats, I don't know, again, if this will make it into production or if it will be three passenger seating in the rear. And then just a look overall at the vehicle inside, you can see that it is quite spacious, but it is also quite minimalist as well. There's also a really sort of deep-seated, sort of driver information display, really sort of very distant from the driver, but again, adding more context to the road and what's happening with the vehicle as the driver is driving. There's the yoke style wheel, driving or steering wheel, I should say. And that yoke style really is meant to help the driver engage with the car. And you can see that there are two screens here. One would be for the mirrors or just to provide information to the driver. And then there are the two monitors to the right. Now, while those look like they might be for the passenger, we had a chance to experience the Lexus VR 360 experience, virtual reality experience, and those monitors really are meant to augment the driver experience. So they are not intended solely for the passenger, but they do provide a lot of augmentation and really sort of context around the driving experience for the driver. So it will be interesting to see how that's going to really play once the car reaches production. There's still some time before 2026, so there's an opportunity for Lexus to do some very cool things with that dual display. So a unique feature of the Lexus LFZC is that it will use steer-by-wire technology. And what that means is that there's no linkage to steer the vehicle or even modulate the steering of the vehicle. It will be entirely digital. Also, Lexus LFZC is going to have all-wheel drive system, and that sort of powertrain or that drivetrain is currently in place with the Lexus RZ. That will continue in the Lexus LFZC. Now, this car adopts a three-box design, and so this would be from the rear to the middle and on to the front. And what Lexus is going to use is gigacasting technology, which breaks the manufacture and assembly of the car into the three different pieces. In the middle part of the car here, you can actually sort of, you will find the battery located right here. And what Lexus is trying to accomplish with that is sort of the modularity, being able to incorporate different types of batteries as battery technology improves. Now, Lexus says that this car will have up to 1,000 kilometers of range with next generation battery technology. We've heard Toyota talk about solid state batteries. They're targeting 2027 for mass production, so I don't know if it will make it into this Lexus, but the point is right here is that through the combination of design, efficiency, and battery technology, Lexus says that they can get 1,000 kilometers of range from the Lexus LFZC. If you look at the profile of this car right here, this car has roughly a 0.2 drag coefficient. And so that basically means it's one of the most efficient EVs that you can find out there in terms of aerodynamics. Now, again, this is a concept model. We don't know what the final production model will be, but certainly based on all appearances here, it will be very efficient in terms of its aerodynamic design. So this is the Lexus LFZC. Tell me, what do you think about it? And it will be coming from Lexus in production form in 2026. And we look forward to see what its final product is when it comes out.